Hi, my name is Kate Lapane, and I'm a professor of epidemiology at Virginia Commonwealth University in Richmond, Virginia. I'm a researcher who focuses on medication issues in older adults, and in particular in an underserved communities. So we used the low-tech approach. We went with developing DVDs that we could be used with standard equipment that most people have, their TVs and a DVD player. We also wanted to use DVD format because some of the concepts that we're trying to teach in the videos may take watching multiple times, and we thought the DVD concept would be an easy way for an older adult to share information about their conditions with family members and friends who are helping them so that they can help them adhere to their medications. The beauty of the DVD system is that our algorithms are written in a way that they can work with data streams of active medication records from any data system, including electronic medical records, electronic health records, electronic prescribing systems. As long as these systems can output the data in text format, it can interface and create individualized DVDs for an older adult. Writing the algorithms was easy. We used SAS, and it was just a series of if-then statements. Based on the specific medications, it would pull off specific video segments related to whether or not they were on the medications. I'm a quantitative researcher, but I also know the limits of the data sources that I use to evaluate medication-related issues. So when I was assembling the team, I realized that I wanted somebody who was expert in qualitative research methods to help us reach out to the populations that I wanted to engage to help me understand more about what's happening behind these numbers that we see and really understand what is it that we need to address.
I'm Roberta Goldman. I'm an anthropologist and professor in family medicine at Brown University. And I was involved in this project from the beginning through the end. So in the beginning, we did what we call exploratory focus groups, three with Spanish-speaking Latinos, four with non-Hispanic whites, and four with non-Hispanic. different racial and ethnic groups, different hair types, different body shapes, different decades within the older adult range, and male and female, so that really, hopefully, anybody who was in the study would be able to resonate with the kinds of images that they were seeing on the screen.
Hola, Maria.
Hola, ¿cómo está?
We clearly were filling a gap. Folks, even if they had had diabetes and heart failure for years, were learning things from these videos that they did not know. We learned that older adults, they just assumed that all of their physicians communicated effectively with each other and that they all knew about all the medications that each healthcare provider was prescribing because it's all in the computer. So we understood that there was a miscommunication there about medications. So we wanted to reinforce in our videos that we need to know as their healthcare team and they need to know as the patient.
So you're working on the script?
Yeah, we're getting close. I wanted you to check a couple of things about.
Patient-centered care focuses on empowering patients, activating them to really be in control of their diseases instead of the diseases being in control of them. So the patient-centered medical concept that we worked with was to use technology, in this case, tailored DVDs, to augment the interactions that occur in the office setting. Our approach was to directly deal with the differences in culture and language related to medication adherence issues and some of the health disparities that we see in the care of chronic diseases.
This approach may be useful for other researchers because patients are used to getting information on their TVs and they get it for entertainment, so why not get educational information about health problems in the same format? Overall, we learned that the patients were receptive to this intervention. They really enjoyed the educational materials, they watched them, and that this avenue for education materials for older adults and medication issues offers hope.